the current crop insurance scheme, which is called the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, has anyway been a tremendous, it has come out a cropper. Everywhere in the country, tremendous resistance is building up, tremendous discontent is there. Number one, precisely because among the farmers, the impression has spread far and wide that this scheme is not to benefit farmers as such, but basically this scheme has been designed to benefit only the corporate insurance companies. And there are so many number of figures regarding this which are available, where the farmers have got not less than 3% of the premium that has been paid back to them, whereas nearly 95% plus premium has gone only to the insurance companies, who are basically corporate companies. Now they have started a thing asking them to the farmers to fill online applications. Now in the rural areas, it's a notorious fact, internet is not working in most of the rural areas, and therefore online applications by the farmers for the crop insurance scheme is actually an exercise in futility. And in fact, the government is doing it precisely because they don't want farmers and the applications to come, so that they are very sure and they can say that we have got a very limited number of applications for crop insurance, and that is why this situation is going on. Now, but this is creating a lot of discontent and unrest among farmers, that in this situation, neither are their applications, they are possible to fill, they cannot even be submitted, and therefore, once the application is not submitted, getting any crop insurance benefit is naturally out of the question. And therefore, this is a absolutely big hoax that is being played out by the central government and the state government, led by the BJP. And this is also another major issue that we have also added in our 14th August Rasta Roko agitation all over Maharashtra. Today, another very major issue that the peasantry of Maharashtra is facing is the question of drought. 3 years earlier, continuously there was drought in Marathwada, large parts of Vidarbha. Last year was a comparatively better year as far as rains are concerned. But this year again, drought has raised its head in most of the districts of Marathwada, in most of the districts of Vidarbha, and also in many districts of Western Maharashtra, Northern Maharashtra, etc. And therefore, this is a repeat performance of the drought that we had seen 3 years earlier. Now, on this issue, we have taken this up on the 14th August agitation. We have demanded from the government that drought measures must be taken on a war footing. These relate to water. These relate to work under the Manrega scheme. Maharashtra is one of the worst states, having one of the worst records as far as the implementation of Manrega is concerned. Of course, as all of us know, the Manrega is being watered down by the BJP central government all over the country. The outlay for Manrega is being cut, and therefore, what is a nationwide phenomenon, we are seeing here in Maharashtra also, that the Manrega is being implemented in an extremely unsatisfactory and lackadaisical manner. So therefore, the question of employment, that is one of the very important things of drought. The question of compensation for crop loss is another important thing. And also another question of giving fodder to the cattle. So these are four of the important things. Also the waiving of fees for college and school students, those as a result of drought. So these are some of the major issues that we are going to take up on the 14th of August agitation. And the drought in various parts of Maharashtra will also be one of the very burning issues that the farmers' movement in Maharashtra will take up all over the state in the coming days. You know, this BJP state government has now brought in a new scheme by which they are asking all the farmers to fill in some forms, giving details of the crop loans, etc., that they have taken. The All India Kisan Sabha is of the clear opinion that this is nothing but a drama that the government is enacting, trying to make a show that now they are really very serious about this loan waiver, etc. The reality is that the state government is very knowledgeable, has every single knowledge regarding the crop loans taken by farmers all over the state. They have all the figures with them, and actually instead of using those figures and immediately taking the decisions regarding loan waiver, they have started this new business of, you know, filling in forms by the farmers. Actually, what is happening is that they want to create the impression and kind of a hope that something is going to happen. Whereas actually what is happening on the ground is exactly the opposite. As the farmers are filling in the forms, they know what are the various conditions that are attached. And this is, on the contrary, increasing the discontent of the farmers, because they are getting, the whole government is getting exposed in this entire process. And that is why we are very clear of the opinion that there is no reason for the government to ask the farmers to again fill in any forms, etc., regarding their crop loans. They should actually, they have all the information, and that is the information that they have to immediately employ to see that which farmers are eligible and which are not. The real reason why they are doing this is that the number of conditions that they have attached to this loan waiver are such that not even 10% of farmers are really going to benefit from this loan waiver. And that is why when 90% of the farmers are not going to be covered by the loan waiver scheme of the government, which is extremely partial, extremely inadequate, in this situation, definitely we are very sure that the kind of response that the peasantry has given right from the 1st of June, the 10-day peasant strike that took place in Maharashtra, the 5th June Maharashtra Band that took place, and after that, the 15 district conventions all over the state in which over 50,000 farmers took part in spite of the sowing season. We are sure that as a result of these struggle programs, the next call that we have given on the 14th of August, a state level rasta roko agitation, where all national highways and state highways will be jammed. This will be another historic and unprecedented success in Maharashtra on behalf of the farmers' movement in the state.